Kumatingaza, kumatingaza. Shina sai yon falapa. Agata from osa kwa funi bulala. Nishiluja kwa, nishiluja kwa.
Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Abby, and if this is your first time on my YouTube channel, welcome to the family. So from today's topic, you can tell that I have a few summer beauty hacks for you guys. It is fully summer. I don't know which state you're in, but it is fully summer. The sun is shining and I absolutely love summer. I think that is my best weather ever. Like, I absolutely love the sun, but one thing I hate about this weather is that I would put my makeup on and I'm looking so good, and in like 10-20 minutes my makeup is looking like a melted pan. Tell me why. So I decided that for some of you that are going to be on the beach, some of you that are traveling, just generally to look good this summer, I have put together a few beauty hacks that actually work to keep your makeup looking good, waterproof, you know, all of that stuff this summer. And without wasting time, let us get right down to this video. Okay, guys, the number one hack I have for you guys is to look for matte and waterproof foundation from your favorite brands. So during winter, you don't really have to wear matte foundation because the weather is dry, like it's cold, you're not going to sweat. But during summer, it's advisable to switch out to matte foundations, waterproof foundations that is going to last longer on your face. I use Huda Beauty, but if you use Fenty or any other brand, you can just go for, you know, their matte foundations rather than the hydrating ones. The matte foundations would last longer on your face during the summer. You don't have to go outside looking all drippy because that is why I use Huda Beauty. Apart from the fact that Huda Beauty actually is completely full coverage, like it covers my dark spots and everything, I actually like it because it's matte. Like, I could wear my foundation all day, 24 hours. But if you have a brand that you already use, just go for their matte foundations. And I promise you, this is the first step to looking peng this summer. The next hack I have for you guys is Milk of Magnesia Matte Primer or Setting Powders. Now, let's start with the setting powders because it's not like the normal application I'm talking about. If you don't have like a matte primer, or if you want to take extra measures to keep your makeup dry, you can actually put a setting powder on your face, like just dab it on your face like you're rubbing your white powder on your face, and then you apply your foundation. This is going to help your makeup sit longer, same as Milk of Magnesia. I think this is like an old, long tradition and people have been sleeping on it, but I'm here to tell you that Milk of Magnesia actually works. It actually works as a primer, like a matte primer, so you just put it on your skin. So far, there is no disadvantage of using it. Like, I haven't heard anyone say, oh, this thing broke me out. So yes, it's actually safe to use Milk of Magnesia on your face before applying your makeup. It actually helps your makeup to sit on your face for like 4 or 5 hours, if I should say. And matte primer, because matte primer just helps you not do any of these other things if you don't want to do it. So yes, next hack I have for you guys to prevent sweaty eyelids slash nose is to use baking powder. This is 2022, and if you don't bake your makeup, then you are sleeping. I mean, you don't necessarily have to bake with like a baking powder. You can bake with your setting powder, but for summer, it's kind of like an essential to bake your face, because for me, I sweat on my nose, I sweat here on my lip, and I always bake those two areas very well, just because I know that I'm prone to sweating in those areas. So this is basically you knowing your face, knowing your skin, knowing what works for you, knowing everything about yourself, basically. So if you know that you sweat under your eyes, yeah, you should bake under your eyes more, you know. Just, but baking powder is an essential, like that is an essential tip this summer. That's an essential hack that's going to help your makeup look and last better on your face. The next hack I have for you guys today is to spray your sponge with setting spray before using it. And it doesn't necessarily have to be setting spray on your sponge before using it, but it's advisable. For me, I use my sponge damp, like I use my makeup sponge damp, not wet, like not dripping wet that your water is falling off of your sponge, hell no, but just dampen it a little bit because it just helps makeup application sit better. But if you don't want to use water, then you can actually go in with setting spray. And also, don't forget to use setting spray on your face, like after your makeup, because it helps melt your makeup and make it look better, and then it just helps it sit longer on your face. So if you don't have setting spray, make sure you purchase it from Sephora. Do your research on the best ones out there. I'm going to link a couple ones that I know that are good personally in the description box for you. Another hack I have for you guys today is to invest in semi-permanent makeup. like a lash perm, microblading, lashes, you know, the semi-permanent lashes that don't come off like after a day or two, that last like a month. This just helps you look nicer, look better. If you don't want to do like heavy makeup, or for the days you don't actually want to do any makeup, you want to go to the beach without makeup, then you can actually still look put together because you have like your microblading, you have your lashes, you have, you know, that just really, really helps. Eyebrow tinting, all of that stuff helps you look better, helps you look nicer, helps make you, helps your makeup look put together. Next hack I have for you guys, this doesn't have to do with makeup, this just has to do with your skin and the general appearance of your skin, is to wear sunscreen / SPF. I know a lot of black people don't believe in wearing sunscreen, but it actually works. It actually helps prevent you from getting breakouts, from hyperpigmentation, you know, all of that stuff. And the weather is scorching, like the sun is gonna be scorching and it's really, really hot. And this is gonna affect your skin. If you have sensitive skin, if you're prone to hyperpigmentation, I would advise you to get your favorite sunscreen or SPF from a trusted brand. I'm gonna do my research and put the one that everybody uses. I use the one from Paula's Choice, but maybe most people might not be able to get this. So I'm gonna do my research and put like the best one in the market out there, the most affordable one for you guys. Next tip I have for you guys today is to get blotting powders or white translucent powders that can help eliminate oils without adding any extra coverage to your makeup. So blotting powders is very essential. I don't know, you can check on Amazon, you can check on Sephora, they have different brands. And you can also get like white translucent powders that you can just apply. So for blotting powders, I think you just use it, dab it where the oil is, and then it takes out the oil without applying any extra coverage to your makeup. And even translucent powders too, same as translucent powders, they don't add any extra coverage. They just help take out the oil or any extra shine that you get on your makeup like during the day. So that is very essential. Tip I have for you today is to rock a sleek bun. This doesn't really have anything directly to do with makeup, but it kind of does. Because for me, I noticed that when I wear a bun, even in the winter, like generally, when I rock a sleek bun like this, even with my natural hair, it actually makes my makeup pop. I don't know why, but for some reason, it just brings out your face. And during summer, it's not advisable to wear like hairstyles that will fall on your face because it's really, really hot. And you know, if there's stuff on your face, then it makes you sweat faster and then it affects your makeup. So basically, rocking a sleek bun actually helps your makeup look better and stay longer in your face. I mean, it's indirectly, but it's kind of direct. Next tip I have for you guys today is to carry baby powder with you everywhere. Like, you can actually buy a baby powder, then buy a little container that you can put it, like you can put it in and then have it in your bag. I don't know which city in the United States you're watching from, but in Chicago, it gets really, really hot during the summer. Like, I literally sweat, no matter what, I sweat in my armpits, in between my thighs, under my boobs. So I always have baby powder for those times where, at least if I cannot put the baby powder under my boobs, I can put it between my thighs before I go out. And even when I go out, like, it doesn't have to be too much and like so obvious that someone can see. But, you know, baby powder actually helps. Next hack I have is to get waxed. Wax your armpits, wax your legs, wax your hands, wax your chin. Remember I said wax? Wax your chin. Wax everywhere that needs to be waxed. Because you're going to be outside and you're going to be in shorts, you're going to be in bikinis. You don't want your leg looking hairy. You don't want your armpits looking hairy. That's generally a turn off. Like, even for a lady, that's a turn off. So wax everywhere that needs to be waxed. Stock up on your beauty products. You know, you want to look very, very good this summer. You want to live your best life. So, babes, I hope you guys come prepared. Summer 2022 is going to be a vibe, hopefully. Fingers crossed. And I hope with these few tips I've given you guys, with these few hacks, you're going to like smash this summer. Okay. So these are my hacks for when it comes to the summer. If you're going out, for those of you that are going to be traveling, going on vacation, those of you that are going to be on the beach, apply these hacks, okay? And if you actually get to use any of these hacks, let me know in the comment section. And if you have any other hacks that, you know, is going to be helpful and I haven't mentioned in this video, leave it in the comment section so that those of you that are watching this video can also see and learn from, basically. And if someone tells you you're sweating this summer, tell them that it is not sweat, it is glow. Glow from the inside, okay? That is if you don't apply these hacks. Anyway, thank you guys for watching, thank you for sticking around, and I hope I see you guys in my next video. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and leave a comment in the comment section. Make it interactive. I love to read you guys' comments. I love to reply you guys' comments. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye. Oh, I forgot. I hope you enjoy your summer.